So I work with the microorganisms from that are isolated from the facility where they build the spacecraft. And we're working on trying to figure out whether or not the cleaning reagents that they use to wipe down these facilities actually serve as food sources for the microorganisms in the facilities. As the pandemic sort of decreases in severity, we'll have access to the microorganisms that were isolated from the spacecraft and the facilities where it was built from. And we'll get to see whether or not some of those microorganisms that may have been blasted off with the spacecraft, though under the policy limits, perhaps they are active and perhaps they could use small organics as carbon sources, which some of these organics may be perhaps already present in the Martian soil and regolith. In summary, my work revolves around the microorganisms from Earth that could hijack a ride on the spacecraft towards Mars. So my research almost ends there, but it does connect up to what happens on Mars in that perhaps there are small organic molecules on Mars that have carbon and nitrogen and or sulfur atoms in there that could serve as food sources. And so I think my work does relate indirectly to what could happen on Mars in that if we find that the microorganisms that could have hijacked on these spacecraft use some of these organic molecules and carbon sources, then maybe if there was enough water and the temperature was right, they could also survive on Mars. That would, I think, really inform some of the work that we are doing or proposed to do in my lab here at Cal Poly.